Okay students, so today we will solve another numerical for the class 10 electrical, electricity chapter, electrical circuits. This will be the last one for this video, and from now on we will be moving on towards the next chapter. Okay? So the circuit is somewhat like this. So we have four resistors connected in such a way, battery or a cell of 3 volts, and you are supposed to find the reading of ammeter. That means you have to find the current flowing in the circuit. Now obviously, just like the previous questions, you will need to find the total resistance of the circuit. You are supposed to find the total resistance of the circuit. In order to understand that, you will have to try to solve this complicated circuit over here and understand what resistors are connected in which way, so that you can find a total resistance, give them a proper series or parallel combination. Now like I said, every single time you have to understand the flow of electric current. Okay, let's say that the total current is flowing in the circuit this way. Correct? Now as soon as it reaches this point, it is going to split up into two wires, obviously. So one of the current will be flowing this way, that will be current I1, and one of the current this way, that is current I2. Now when this current flows from this side, we know that these two wires are in parallel. That means the resistors in that side will be parallel to each other. But when this current I1 moves ahead, you will see that this current I1 passes through 2 ohms resistor, and that same current passes through 4 ohms resistor as well. Which means that the same current passes through 2 and 4, and hence this resistor, the 2 ohm resistor and the 4 ohm resistor, they both are in series. Okay? So we can write in such a way that resistance RS1 is equal to 2 ohms plus 4 ohms, that is equal to 6 ohms. Now similarly, in the same manner, you will see that the current I2 is in this way. And so the same current I2 passes through this 3 ohm resistor and this 3 ohm resistor as well. So these two are in series once again. So we can write resistors in series 2, that will be 3 ohms plus 3 ohms, and you get the answer as 6 ohms once again. So these two were in series and these two were in series. Now this current I1 meets over here and I2 over here once again. That means these two wires are in parallel to each other. Or in short, if you want to simplify this circuit, draw it like this. So this will be 2, 4, 3 and 8. In this one you can clearly understand what is happening. That this 2 and 4 are in series, this 3 and 3 are also in series. The total of this and the total of this, they will be parallel to each other. So now that we have resistors RS1 and RS2, these two are parallel to each other. And so, you can write the resistors in parallel, and in order to find the resistors in parallel, you have to take the reciprocal. So we do that. The total resistance 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon RS1 plus 1 upon RS2. Simply substitute the values, which will be equal to 1 upon 6. Plus 1 upon 6, answer is 2 upon 6, which will be 2, 1 and 2 is 6, 1 by 3. But remember, this is 1 by R. In order to find the total resistance, you have to do the inverse of this. So it will be R is equal to 3 ohms. So now you have the total resistance of the whole combination, that is this whole part, you have the total resistance now. That will be 3 ohms. Okay? Now that you have the 3 ohm resistor, you have all the values you need to find the current in the circuit. And so, V is equal to IR. V is given as 3 volt. Current I you need to find, and resistance as 3 ohms once again. So, 3 will be in denominator. Therefore, 3 by 3 is equal to I. It will be 3 ones is 3, and therefore I is equal to 1 ampere. This is how you find the current flowing in the circuit. I hope this numerical was understood to you students quite easily.